first one with all five of us in an episode together, which is good to have. On this episode, we'll talk about Tomasz Kuszczak and his performances and whether he's ready to take over from Edward van der Sar when he retires. Nani's petulance in recent games. So who will be the third highest scorer, presuming Rooney and Berbatov, 1 and 2. Also, we'll speak a little bit about the first League Cup game of the season. Also, we'll touch on a comment from a person on YouTube and show you how you can also write in with a question for us. But first of all, Miles, you've got a quiz question for us.
Yeah, this week, it's the Owen Hargreaves theme, seeing as he's come back to training, and the question is, in which city was Owen Hargreaves born?
So have a think about that one, and we'll touch on that one at the end of the show. Now, the first topic for this week is Tomasz Kuszczak and his Man of the Match performance in the League Cup during the week. Now, I personally think maybe he's a chance to be the first-choice keeper after van der Sar retires. Now, I know there's a few of you that don't agree. First of all, Will, what are your thoughts on Kuszczak, and is he ready to take the mantle?
Well, I think in the games that he's played so far this season, he's shown that he can, you know, certainly be a successor to van der Sar. But I think he's just on the cusp of getting into the first team at the moment. There are other keepers that we've been linked to, and obviously he may choose to go down the same path as Foster in terms of if he doesn't get regular football, he'll want to leave the club. So I think Fergie, if he wants to keep him, has to give him a few more games, and obviously Edwin's getting a bit older now. So
yeah, there's been a bit of a talk that he's getting a bit frustrated with being sat on the bench for most of the time at United. I've said it before in a previous episode that I don't think he's a Champions League quality keeper. I think he's a very solid backup and a good player to have there, but I probably wouldn't like to see him be first choice in the future, in a year or two when van der Sar retires. But I'd be more than happy to see him stay on his second choice.
Yeah, Miles, what are your thoughts on Kuszczak?
Well, he's certainly done his chances no harm by performing well in the latest League Cup game, and hopefully when he does get the chances, you know, even if they're very few, the first team, that he does step up and shows what a quality keeper he can be. And if he can do that, then I wouldn't mind seeing him as first choice once van der Sar leaves. Give him a chance. He's done his apprenticeship for a while, so.
Now, something the commentators are keen to talk about is Nani's petulance and the way he carries on a bit during the games. In particular, last Premier League game where he went down in the box and didn't really seem to get touched at all. Now, I have to say that we're all big fans of Nani, especially since he's come on and he's got bags of confidence, but he does tend to carry on a bit and maybe shows he's a bit immature. What are your thoughts on that, Josh?
Well, I think we've talked a bit about this before. I think it's something which is going out of his game, certainly as he matures. And he's still pretty young and he's still got that side to his game. But I think you see a lot of Portuguese players who are quite petulant.
I think we've just got to accept that that's part of, at the moment, that's part of his game, really. Like, yeah, it's not going to go away instantly. It's always obviously going to be weeded out slowly, and no one was really complaining when Ronaldo was doing it, scoring 42 goals in a season, so hopefully he goes down the same path.
Yeah,
it's not something you like to see your players doing. I personally, watching the game, felt sort of a bit annoyed at him for doing that sort of thing and acting like that because, well, it's not the way I like to see players for United playing, so yeah, hopefully he can gradually get that out of his game.
Now, we talked in the last episode about Rooney and Berbatov. After Berbatov's early season form, will Rooney catch up and who will be the highest scorer? Now, something that we're going to talk about now is who do you think will be providing the rest of the goals amongst the midfielders, and could be someone like Nani, like we were just talking about. First of all, Males, who do you think is going to pop up and be probably the third highest goal scorer,
well,
if you presume they're the first two?
After the midweek League Cup match, I'd probably like to see Michael Owen given a bit more first team action, and I think if he's only given sort of 10 or 12 Premier League starts and then has another, you know, 15, 20 sub appearances, that sort of thing, I think he could score a handy amount of goals and definitely crucial times, so probably he would be my next option. But we need a bit from our midfielders, and Scholes has provided a bit, and Nani's providing the assists and a few goals, and Fletcher as well. So mean, there's a few popping up. There's a lot of options to goal, which is good.
I think Hernandez, similar to what Mayo said, if he gets a few Premier League games and a few appearances off the bench, we've seen how good he is at finishing and getting into positions. So once he gets used to being at United and being in England, I think he could score a fair few goals.
Especially with the current dip in form that Rooney's having, we might be seeing him brought, Owen and Hernandez brought into the fray a bit more.
Yeah,
well, it's interesting you say that, because you have to wonder what Fergie is going to do, whether he's going to try and play Rooney into form, which could cost us a few goals and even, you know, some games because we're losing some goals, or whether he's going to put Owen, Makeda and Chicharito in there. To try and get the goal straight away, so interesting to see how it would go.
I think it's more going to be a case of not dropping Rooney from the starting 11 more, if they're going to substitute another striker on, doing it earlier in the game and giving them a bit more time. Like, instead of giving them 10-15, they might give them half an hour.
Just returning to what we were talking about a bit earlier, I think that I agree with Nick about Nani, who will provide a lot of the goals. So I think he'll probably be the, probably count him as a midfielder. So I think he'll be the one, the midfielder, to score the most. But I think Michael Owen will probably just sneak ahead. Now, Owen Hargreaves, a player we haven't seen in a while, who we mentioned in the quiz question a bit early on, has resumed full training. Tell us a bit more about that, Josh, and what it means for United.
Yeah, well, Fergie's come out and said that he's surprised with how well he's progressing, Hargreaves, and that he's going to give him a first-team option sooner than he thought, which is great news because he's really the only true defensive midfielder at the club. And I think when we've got big Champions League games coming up in the second round and beyond, when he's got the chance to get back in the Champions League squad, then it's going to be a real asset for us, because when we're playing that 4-5-1, there's no one else at the club who can play quite like Hargreaves can in that holding midfield role.
And he's also got a lot of Champions League experience.
Yeah.
Of course, winning it, but
yeah. Yeah, certainly right. Remember back when we won it, him harassing the opposition's midfield in the latter stages of the Champions League, and just the energy of him, and just always seemed to be in their faces, and certainly a good player to have just at that
extent. It's going to be exciting when he comes back, but I think we've got to take pretty much everything that's said about Owen Hargreaves with a grain of salt, just because of the history of the injury over the last 2 years, really.
But yeah. I think if he does come back and he's at full fitness, obviously he won't be match fit when he comes back, but when he comes back, I think it's going to be like a reinvigorated player, because you just have to think how hungry he's going to be to play and win, because he would have nearly lost faith that he's ever going to play football again so many times during his rehab and in America. So I think it'll be hugely invaluable during games.
We previously talked a lot about the about United's of late conceding goals late on in the matches, and I think that if he's on the park, that'll help. That'll go a long way to sorting that out.
Yeah, as we talked about it when we were talking about the captaincy issue. He's the type of Gary Neville type player, the real leader, Roy Keane type midfielder that we're sort of missing a bit at the moment in our first team. Exactly. So, you could really add that as well.
Now, the first League Cup game was on about a week ago, and against Scunthorpe United. It was a great game, plenty of goals in the 5-2 win for United. Now, there's a few unfamiliar faces and players that needed a game under their belt. Now, first of all, to ask you, Will, what did you think of the game and the players that you saw?
Yeah, I thought it was quite a pleasing performance from a reserve United side, if you like. It was obviously good to see Rio Ferdinand back, and to point out that his partner on the night, Chris Smalling, had a great game. He got an assist and scored a goal as well, and just generally looked quite solid back there. So it was good to see him, and also the introduction of our new signing from Portugal, Bebe. A lot had been spoken about how the press didn't think he was a good player for United, and he was signed without Fergie even seeing him play. So to see him in a United shirt was quite pleasing for me, and he looks a really handy player. He's quite big and strong, and his footwork on the night was quite good as well. So.
And as we talked about earlier with the goals, Michael Owen got two goals. One of them was obviously just a tap in. The other one was probably a textbook Michael Owen finish, if you like. So he got the ball pretty much on halfway and decided early which way I was going to go with the keeper and slid it inside the far post. So it's good to see him getting back, because that'll do no end of good for his confidence. So that obviously gives us another option off the bench or starting if Rooney keeps up the way he is.
And he looked quite sharp, Owen, when he was through on goal there. He still got that change of pace to get through and get beyond that last defender, and he's still still as composed as when he was playing at Liverpool. You know, he's slotted the ball easily inside the near post.
Yeah, never looked like missing like that clinical finishing, something that hopefully you keep, you know.
Josh, just want to get your thoughts on Bebe. Where do you see him in terms of Premier League starts or maybe on the bench? What do you think about that?
Well, I think he's still behind Squiddy in the pecking order on the wings. He's still probably got a fair way to go with training and getting a few more reserve games under his belt. I think the main issue is his fitness isn't up to Premier League standard at the moment. So I think it'll be a little while before we see him fully into the first team. But
I tend to agree with you there. I think that he won't probably be looking for too many starts this year. Probably only get a handful of Premier League starts, if that. And I think most of his appearances will come off the bench.
So. I think that it'll be around February or something that he could... you might think about giving him one or two against some of the lower table teams, and you know, it might not necessarily be a start, might also, you know, be playing half an hour here or there.
Well, with cups as well.
Yeah. With the injury to Valencia, it really does open the door for him to have a few appearances. But as Josh mentioned, Gabriel Obertan has got to be up there, up there next in line. I think he's done his time in the reserves and he's performed quite well.
And on just one more positive note from that night, it was good to see Mike Phelan in trousers.
Yeah.
we hadn't seen that in previous weeks. He'd been wearing the very short shorts. So it was good to see.
He had a bit of a laugh as well when the streaker came on.
Yeah.
That was a bit of nudity.
The commentator said, well, that's even enough to wipe the smile off his face when they showed the camera and he was laughing his head off with
John O'Shea. John O'Shea, I think he was in particular.
I think the whole crowd was. Now, whenever you wanted to, you can submit questions or comments on our Facebook or YouTube account. And we'll do our best to answer what you say on the show. Now, we've got one for this week from Johnny Love Football 10. And he's said a great performance about from Berbatov in the game just gone in the Premier League, but saying how he needs to be consistent and he hopes Rooney can get back to form soon. But he has asked about his countrymate Chicharito and what do we think about him and where's he going to feature. Now, first I'll ask you, Josh, what are your thoughts on Hernandez?
Yeah, well, first of all, thanks for your question, Johnny. But secondly, I think I mentioned it earlier in the show, I think he's possibly going to be the third top scorer this season, getting a few games, especially if Rooney, as I say, keeps on not performing so well. I think he's going to get a fair few games this season. I think at the moment he's probably third choice striker, although it's pretty tight between him and Makeda and Owen. But yeah, I think he's a very promising player, and of course we praised him a fair bit after his World Cup, which was very impressive, and his pre-season as well. So I think he's going to be a very good signing.
I think he's settling down now as well after the World Cup, and when he first came to England there was a lot of hype around him, and he of course scored in the Charity Shield, and everyone was talking about how he's going to...
Quite a funny goal, that one.
Everyone was talking about how he's going to, you know, hit the ground running in the Premier League and score a ton of goals. And I think that now the reality has set in that he's got to work slowly to adapt to England. And he has definitely got a lot of talent. And I think that he's going to score a lot of goals for us. But it's going to take time for him to adapt to the way the team works and just the way England works.
Yeah, well, exactly. Because he obviously knows how his national team in Mexico plays. So it's going to take a while to work out where he fits in the game structure during games to get into the right position and score from, you know, inside or outside the box. Now, before we wrap up this episode of Red Talk, Miles has got the answer for the quiz question, so I hope you've been thinking about that one.
Yeah, once again, the question was, which city was Owen Hargreaves born in? And the answer is Calgary in Alberta, Canada. So even though he's playing for England, he was actually originated from Canada.
He had a choice of three countries to play for, I think, so... Yeah, played for England, as you probably are aware. That's it for this episode of Red Talk, and we'll see you next time. Well, this episode is Tomasz Kuszczak in his man of the match performance against Scunthorpe United in the first league.
Stop! Stop it,
today.